Howdy, everybody. It's your old pal, Jazz McKay here. And if you were watching last night, the president was debating. It was supposed to be a town hall, but actually it was a debate between President Donald Trump and NBC's Savannah Guthrie in Miami. You might have noticed a lady sitting behind Donald Trump nodding her head in agreement with almost everything that he said. I mean, I honestly, how could you miss her, right? Well, she drove the liberals absolutely nuts all night long, and they were determined to sick the dogs on her. But as it turns out, I think it backfired on them because she's become something of a hero to us Trump supporters, and doxing her has really had no effect whatsoever because she's always been very open about her patriotism and her love of President Donald Trump. So it's not like they're going to embarrass her or get her fired or anything. See, it turns out that the nodding lady, which is how she's been referred to, is in fact an immigration lawyer from Miami, actually Coral Gables, Florida, by the name of Myra Jolly. And she's an immigrant herself from the Dominican Republic. She ran for Congress in Florida's 27th district in 2018 as an independent. On her law firm's official website, it says that Jolly practices exclusively in immigration law, and her specialty is detention and removal proceedings. The profile goes on to say that Jolly is one of the most active immigration lawyers in South Florida, and that she has litigated cases across the United States. She attended law school at the Autonomous University of Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic, graduated in 1989. She was conferred by the Supreme Court of Louisiana in 2001. She's a member of the American and Federal Bar Association. She founded the Jolly Law Firm, her own law firm, back in 2012. In addition to her legal career, she has also won the Mrs. Coral Gables Beauty Pageant in 2015. She's married to her husband, who's also a lawyer. His name is Stephen Befra. They've been married since 1995. Oh, and Stephen is a former Marine. She's awesome. And like I said, she is a proud Trump supporter. She has campaigned for the president, and she attends rallies and supports her president and her country. God bless America. Now, like I said, she has become something of a hero, an icon to us deplorables, because she's everything we love and admire and respect. She's a strong, independent woman. She's an immigrant. She's a minority. She's a patriot who loves her country. In other words, she's everything that the liberals in this country hate. Now, there were a lot of positive comments last night on Twitter from Trump supporters. Absolutely love the black woman in the background of the real Donald Trump town hall who's nodding along and agreeing with President Trump. NBC obviously made a mistake by letting her in. Oops. This tweet goes out to the woman nodding for Trump. Retweet this so she sees it. She deserves a medal. And these tweets, just examples, just some examples of the positive tweets that were out there last night, applauding this woman, saying, hey, man, that's awesome. Because, again, like I said, she represents what we as conservatives celebrate about this country. She's an immigrant, a woman of color, and she's a patriot. And these are all things that liberals hate. Like this little thread here. Wow, how can I get paid to sit behind Trump and nod at everything he says and look at the response? I'm feeling a lot of rage about this. The woman responds, says, same. The woman is nodding at things before he's even finished a thought. It's a psychological trick, and I cannot believe no producer, no camera person, no one is stopping it. They became unhinged. And this yutz who seems to think that she was a MAGA plant, not just a supporter, but probably an actual campaign staffer. Heads should roll at NBC. More like heads are exploding on the left. And then you got this kook, man. He was tweeting. I must have counted 40, 45 tweets from him last night, just freaking out over the nodding lady, journalist if you don't find out who that woman is nodding behind Trump at an undecided voter town hall, then I don't know what you're getting paid for. And, dutifully, the journalist at the Miami Herald did just that. Yep, within 30 minutes, the Miami Herald doxed her. The Miami Herald, that's doxing is the job of journalists? Then this guy, Tom Nichols, again, you know, he's going nuts, Googling her and researching her, and says that she was a congressional candidate who was endorsed by the local Proud Boys. Now, wait a minute. I thought the Proud Boys were a bunch of white supremacist racists, and they were endorsing a black woman for Congress? Pretty much debunks that whole theory that the Proud Boys are a bunch of white supremacist racists. They're endorsing a black woman for Congress. Jesus. And there were more than one or two responding to Mr. Nichols and pointing out the fact that these people are seriously suffering from Trump derangement syndrome, which is an understatement. In fact, the more offensive tweets I won't even include in this because of the level of racial hatred that was being spewed. You see, the left becomes totally enraged when a person of color wanders off of the plantation and actually starts thinking for themselves, which is the true nature of the left. The fact is, they're no different than their 19th century counterparts when it comes to runaway slaves. They'll hunt them down and inflict severe punishment on them as a warning to others to stay in line and not try to even think about escaping. God bless Myra Jolly and all the other nodding ladies out there for their courage and their bold tenacity. Keep up the good fight. I got your six. Well, thanks for watching. Be sure and like this video. Subscribe to my channel. Share to your social media. And leave nasty comments below. God bless America and death to the New World Order.